So you've got your weapon of choice. You've got the clothing, the gloves, the boots, the helmet. Now it's time to talk about the most difficult aspect of airsoft. Let's talk eye protection. When I first got into the sport of airsoft, I, like most people, went out, looked at some Gucci pictures and decided that's the kit I want, and I went out and bought it. And so far, that hasn't been an issue. I've really enjoyed the clothing that I've bought, and I think it feels good, and it's been a learning lesson, kind of from day one. Now, an experienced airsofter once told me when I was getting into the sport, the most difficult and the most important aspect of any single part of airsoft is eye protection. It really, really is an individual thing here. Yes, a lot of this is going to go on the type of look and the type of feel that you want, but it also comes down to the amount of eye protection that you want and you need. And also, having looked at a lot of these pieces of goggles and glasses, it's completely different just putting them on in the shop than it is to actually getting in the field and using this and bringing a rifle or a weapon up to your cheek and actually looking down the sights. Everything changes. And in this video, I'm going to explain to you some of the things that I've encountered, some of the glasses and the goggles and the eye protection that I've been using on the field, and the negatives and pros for all of them. A lot of the footage in this video is going to be quite old. It was spare footage that I never got around to doing, but I thought it's quite important, as recently I tried a new pair of goggles out on the field, and I'll explain my experiences with those and whether it's actually worth putting some more dollar down and the different types of eyewear that might be suitable for your type of play. So this is the first pair of eye protection that I actually bought when I was buying all my kit. And like most people out there, I went out and bought, you know, accessories, gloves, boots, slings, everything else, and the money was just getting carried away, and I thought, you know what, I don't want to spend too much now, but really, the eye protection is the most important thing that you can have in airsoft. So I saw these, and these were only $12.99. And it said on them they were Bolly, which I've heard of before. Really good eye protection. These were light. They gave that sort of sporty look. And the advantage to these is that you could have easily put face protection on and they weren't going to get in the way. But as you can see here, that where I'm marking, there is quite a large gap under the cheek, meaning BBs can, if you shot from the side or from behind, they are actually going to go under these glasses. And the last thing you want to get is a BB in the face. Trust me, it's painful. And anywhere near your eyes is a serious, serious health issue. So this is something to consider, and I'll explain why these are good for a certain type of player and a certain play style a little bit further into the video. But these were the first pair of eye protection that I actually wore. They never fog ever, because they've got good airflow. They're really light. You can get them under a helmet or wear a balaclava, and they still do not fog up on the field. So in that aspect, these are absolutely fantastic. You're not going to be able to break these either. They're really sort of lightweight, even though these are bulletproof, or should I say BB proof. Not bad for $12.99. Next up, I decided to invest a little bit more. These are the Bolly X1000s, and they are a little bit more on the expensive side. But having played my first game with those clear glasses and getting shot just under the nose on the cheek, realizing how much it friggin' will hurt, I thought the last thing I want to do is lose an eye or get any sort of eye injury. So I thought, do you know what? I'm not going to risk it. I'm going to spend a little bit more money on eye protection, which I should have done from the beginning, really. So I bought these. As you can see, you've probably, for $54.99, you've probably played a tenner for the case, but let's just put that to one side, all joking aside. So these are completely clear. They are extremely solid. And the main downside to this originally when I put them on was, you see the shape of it. It is like wearing a diving mask. The actual squared off sides do interfere a little bit with your peripheral vision. The actual casing itself, the actual protection here, is fantastic. This is really thick, solid plastic. And it's very clear, but I've actually scratched these from having a little bit of mud on my finger and actually wiping it. And as you can see, underneath, on the top and the bottom here, are these little foam inserts. And as you can see, I've actually drilled some more holes in here. This is because I've had nothing but trouble with these, with fogging. It was absolutely terrible. Now, these were supposed to be, you know, brilliant for airsofting. And while they feel great, if you're not running around in the field, these are really good. If you tend to play a little bit more on the assault side and you get hot and sweaty, they're just terrible, absolutely terrible. Even, I mean, if you wear a balaclava or anything like that, your breath goes straight up through the nose piece, through the foam inserts at the bottom. Hence, that's why I put the drill marks in and ripped the foam out. I even tried some of the Bolly anti-fog liquid in here, and I tried the old tricks with the shaving foam and the washing up liquid. Anything I could do to stop these fogging up, it just simply couldn't do it. So if you're going to play as a sniper, possibly, or somebody like a DMR or a support class who's further out from the actual action, these will probably be really good for you. But if you're in assault on a hot day and you're running around, you simply cannot get rid of the fog. Whereas the original ones, the cheaper ones, no fog whatsoever, but these really are going to give you some great eye protection around the eyes, the cheekbones, and a little bit of the forehead. So here we are. This is the latest pair of goggles that I've actually got. These are the Smith Optics LoPro Regulator Goggle. Very tactical. Now, I did a little bit of research on the internet, trying to find a solution to this fogging issue, and it was just doing my head in. It really was spoiling my games, actually. And a few people had been using these goggles out in the desert playing airsoft, and a few people had been doing them. Looked like it was up in the Dales or even in Norway and places like that that were really cold, and they were saying these goggles were fantastic. The only issue to that really is that these people were playing milsim, so there's not a lot of running around like a madman, assaulting, falling back, manoeuvring, smoke, you know, the usual stuff. So a lot of their time, they're going to be moving around at quite a slow pace. So I was worried initially about actually spending this amount of dollar on a pair of eye protection, if it was going to mean that I've got the same issues again with fogging. So what do we get for our money out of the box? We get this lovely Molly system, so you can attach this to your webbing, to your backpack, to your leg, or wherever. I don't know why you would want to do that. At no point would I ever want to put my goggles on my actual clothing. But hey-ho, you've got this case, and you've got the option to do it. So let's have a look and see what we actually get in here. First thing we get is a lens cleaning felt, and here's the goggles themselves, and we'll have a look at those, and there's the case. Put that to the side. So they come in this nice, lovely felt little sleeping bag here for the spare lenses. Now, it's nice to actually get some spare lenses. This is a dark tinted one. Very tactical, very cool. And obviously, if you're going for a certain look, I think you know what I'm talking about, these would fit in perfectly. They are absolutely rock solid. The plastic here, the eye protection lens, must be nearly 3-4 millimeters thick. It's absolutely solid. It's probably in the real military, if you were firing, this would probably give you some decent eye protection from shells and casings as well. Now, along the top, you can see there's a series of vents here, and we can open and close those, even with your gloves on. You can open these up, close them, should you want to. Probably best, initially for us, if we keep those open at all times. The lens really does feel like a high-quality piece of plastic. I just want to say as well, I'm not being sponsored to these. I've actually had to pay for these out of my own money, so I'm not giving you any sort of biased opinion here. So here's the actual goggles. And we've all seen on TV the military when they run around, they have them at the front with the casing on. That's what this is, and you simply pull it round to the back, which annoys the hell out of me, to be honest with you, but it's there if you want it. Now, the great thing about these is the actual shape of them. They're extremely curved and very, very low profile. As you can see, there is a massive on the bottom there. There is a massive amount of foam along there. And what I'll do is, before we get into a little bit further into the details of this, I'll give you some of the official blurb for these actual goggles. Now, these goggles were designed with two primary tasks in mind: to integrate under night vision systems and without their mounts, without causing optical interference, and keep the lens from fogging at bay. Well, we'll get to that in a minute. The ambidextrous regulator slides open from either side to allow airflow across the lens, which keeps the lens clear from fog. And the LoPro regulator combats fog, so you don't have to. Now, the features of these are, these lenses meet US MIL DTL 435-11D goggle impact level. I don't know if that means anything to you, it means absolutely nothing to me. Now, the goggles are also the lowest profile full face goggle and easy night vision goggle integration that you can currently buy. They're a Smith patented regulator with ventilated lens that is supposed to combat fogging. Now, Smith Optics are uncompromising, if I can even get that word out, optical quality. The anti-fog and anti-scratch resistant coatings are available on all lenses. And these will also protect you 100% from UVA and UVB rays. And they also come in smoke and clear lenses, which are included. Now, these goggles that you're looking at on screen are actually the limited edition version because these are actually camo. We've got that camouflage strap at the back, and most places they're actually sold out with these goggles. Because these are quite low profile, you can actually get a decent amount of face protection. I want to say face protection, I mean mouth protection. The only downside to this currently with the face protection that I've got is the BBs can actually go under the nose piece, meaning you get twatted on the bridge of your nose. Now, let's talk about the most important aspect of these goggles. Do they fog up, Para? Do they fog up? Can we get a drum roll, please? Yes, they fucking do. But, and here is the but, that you get amazing peripheral vision with those goggles. I'm not going to lie, and the fact that you can change them for tinted ones is very cool. But what I have noticed, again, like I mentioned earlier, these goggles, I found that during assault, running around doing skirmish, if I kept moving, the goggles were perfectly clear. No fogging issues whatsoever. Come to a stop, stand by a log or a cabin, catch your breath back, whoop, can't see a bloody thing. So you end up trying to like wipe on the inside to stop the anti-fog. And what I ended up doing, laughing and joking aside, I was running around in a circle near the log cabins recently to clear me goggles, and the marshals were laughing, saying, "What the fuck are you doing?" I said, "I'm trying to clear me goggles." We were all laughing about it. Carry on running around and they clear instantly. So in that aspect, fantastic. So if you're into assault, these are probably going to be brilliant goggles for you. Now the second set that we looked at, again, not perfect for assault because they fog up immediately. So if you're playing the DMR or a sniper, and you're a little bit further back from the action, these are the goggles that would be perfect for you. A little bit less in the price range, but they're not going to fog up. Really, really good glasses. And because you're going to be quite concentrating down the sight and the scope, the peripheral vision loss, because you're further back from the action, is not going to be a huge issue. Now the cheap glasses at the bottom, fantastic all around really. I don't really want to be wearing those if I'm going into the thick of the action, getting 30-40 BBs in the face when you're assaulting with that, especially if your weapon's down. Not perfect for me. I do worry about getting shot from the side of the eye, from the side, and getting damaged around the eye area. Something I really don't want. But again, if you're playing DMR or you're a sniper and you're further out from the action, absolutely perfect. In regards to actually wearing these with the mesh face protection, I think all three actually fit really well. The actual plastic ones, the goggles, they fit really well under the eye protection. Lots of easy ways to get these on. Not going to be able to wear your night vision goggles, so that's something else for you to think about, and you do lose peripheral. The glasses that we looked at, no problem whatsoever, but you're not going to get the face protection under the cheeks, just under the eyes. So really, out of the three, was it worth me spending the extra money, the extra dollar, to get the expensive ones? Yes, it was. As long as I keep on moving and I keep on running, absolutely worth every single penny. Great peripheral, good quality, you can swap the lenses out, you've just got to put a bit more money down. But with all things in Airsoft, it all comes down to personal preference, your style of play, and how much protection you actually want. And I may in another video go into mouth protection, whether you want to get your teeth smashed out or you want a beautiful Hollywood smile that's stained a little bit by coffee, like I've got, then I'll do that in another video. In the meantime, thumbs up, subscribe, and let me know what you think about your eye protection or any other questions you've got, and I'll try and answer them. In the meantime, I'll see you in another video coming real soon from ParaPlays. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.